The premise of building in Lovable is simple. Enter a prompt, get a result. But to do it the right way, it is a little bit more complicated. I've built dozens of apps using Lovable and other vibe coding tools, and in this video, I'm going to share the secrets that I've learned and the step-by-step instructions of everything you need to know about building in Lovable. If you don't know what Lovable is, it is a vibe coding platform, which means that you can type out what you want, and it's going to write the code for you and give you a workable website or app as the end result. It is one of the fastest growing vibe coding tools, and this video is going to tell you what you need to know to build in it. The first thing you need to know starts before you even get into Lovable, and a lot of people miss that, so let's jump right in. Here we are in Lovable. You might think the first thing when you want to build a Lovable project is to type in this box. First thing we want to do is actually go to something like Claude or ChatGPT, and you're going to want to add this prompt in with both the initial prompt of writing an initial prompt PRD for a Lovable project. PRD stands for product requirements document. This is basically a long document that's going to give the AI more information about what you want it to build. I'm asking it to research best practices for Lovable prompting because if we go into search and tools, we have web search turned on here for Claude. So I like adding things like this when web search is turned on. Then the actual prompt is I want to build an online personality quiz. It can be lead generation where they have to enter their email at the end to get the result. So, of course, you could build anything with Lovable, but I think this could be a cool example here to show you. Now, if we weren't doing this, we would just take this prompt and paste it into Lovable. But if we did that, the result would not be as good. Then I'm going to switch the model to Opus 4. When you are using this method to improve your prompt, it is always good to use a more powerful model. Now, the other benefit of this is that by prompting in Claude or whatever chat app that you want before sending it into Lovable, we're going to get a better initial prompt, just better prompts in general. You can do this for other prompts as well. And this means you're going to spend less money in Lovable and you're using you're using Claude, which you might already be paying for. So it's also a more economical way to do things. So here we go. We have our PRD being written out. And of course, you can also edit it if you want to kind of go deeper. You can go back and forth with the features. For this example, I'm just going to use it as is. And I know we've spent a lot of time doing things before we've even started in Lovable, but you'll see the more work you do up front, the better result you're going to get. And this applies to any vibe coding tool that you're using. So I've copied this prompt, I've pasted it in, and here we are with our first result, discover your professional personality. I think it did a really nice job with this landing page. And let's click start the quiz and let's just test it out really quickly. I'm just gonna like not go through and actually read the questions just because I wanna do it quickly. It is 90% complete. Okay. And here we go. Complete the quiz. Like, this is really impressive for a lead magnet that we did with one prompt. And then here we go. Looks like the design could be a little improved there. But overall, really nice. Your personality profile, strengths, characteristics, famous, the innovators, and then growth tips. Want to dive deeper? Get the PDF. In a second, I'm going to show you how to connect this to a database to actually collect these email addresses. But before I do that, I want to talk about a really important feature of Lovable, which is the chat functionality. So here on the left side, we have our chat. This is where you can ask for new features and chat with the AI to plan out your next features. And you also have on the right side here, the actual preview. So what I want to do is ask it a question, and you can do it to both understand what the app has built and then also plan new features. So what I want to ask it in chat is, how do the questions correspond to the result? Is it real logic? So I want to make sure that what it built out is actually related, and it's not just giving us like a random result. Here we can see Lovable is examining the questions and the calculations to understand how it works. Cool. So this helps me understand what the code is doing. And this is another just helpful tip with Lovable or vibe coding in general. The more you can understand what has been built, the more you're going to be able to manage your app and make changes to it in the future if you want. So here it says the way that it did it was essentially for each question, each answer looks like it's related to one of these personality types. So we are collecting email addresses, but we're not saving them anywhere. So if you want to do this and actually save those email addresses and then potentially also have users log in and have something called authentication. Authentication in an app is when users can log in and log out. We need to connect to Supabase. Supabase is essentially a backend database that integrates really well with Lovable. There are others that are out there, but Supabase is integrated perfectly with Lovable. So this is the one we're going to use here. So if you don't have a Supabase account, you can just go to Supabase, just search Supabase and you'll find it, create an account. I'm going to click connect Supabase because I already have a Supabase account. We're going to connect a project, which I created one before called Test Lovable App. And Lovable and Supabase are going to talk to each other and then connect and then make it very easy to add these additional features, which is having a database, having user authentication, signing in and signing out if you want that. And then it also has something called edge functions, which I'm not going to get into as much in this video, but edge functions allow you to connect to external services such as OpenAI, if you want to have an API call to connect to other services. That's where edge functions would come in. So then I wrote this prompt to say, we are collecting the email addresses. Please save that to the database. You can also ask people to create an account with a password. No need to verify email address, which is basically Supabase by default will ask people to verify the email address, but I don't want to do that for this demo. Something really helpful when you are building with Lovable to ask it to turn that off. And I'll show you in a second in Supabase, there's something we need to do. But this is really helpful just to make it work better with testing. And if they create an account, you can give them a dashboard where they can access more information. For now, make the dashboard just simple. And we can add more later. And chat is turned off, which is what we want. And I'm going to send this off. What's really nice about Lovable is it just talks seamlessly with Supabase. And it's going to build all this out. It's going to write SQL to create the database tables, and it's going to set up authentication, which is the user login and logout functionality. Let me, while it's doing this, I'm going to show you in Supabase one trick that we need to do. So I'm going to go to the top, click on our Supabase to open our Supabase app here. So we're going to go to the left side, go to authentication, go to sign in slash providers. And then when we go down, we're going to go to email. This is where you can add other sign-in providers such as Gmail or all sorts of other ways for people to sign in. And I'm just going to uncheck confirm email and click save. So a little hack that is really helpful to know applies to building with other tools, not just Lovable as well, if you're connecting to Supabase. Of course, you can turn that on in the future and set up email to actually verify those emails, but I prefer to keep that turned off. Then here in Lovable, we have the database tables that it wants to create to store the quiz responses and user profiles. I'm going to click apply changes to basically allow Lovable to generate those tables in Supabase. We always can make changes to this in the future, so don't worry if for some reason it doesn't work. You are able to make changes and we can have, you know, Lovable write SQL. This is called SQL. This is like a code basically. Let's just like quickly go through. And we can always answer more carefully later, but I just want to get a response. Okay, so here it is, quiz complete. Pretty cool. And now we have create an account for personalized dashboard. That's pretty cool. So you can enter your email to just get it without the account, but we can create an account for personalized dashboard. I love that. So I filled out all this. I'm going to click get my personality result. And now it says account created successfully. So we have our result here. Again, that design isn't fully working, but that's fine. Then let's just go to the dashboard here. And then here we are logged in. So we have my personality type, account information, quick actions, and coming soon with more features because I said we can add more later. If we go on the top to Supabase, we can test this, or we can verify this. So we'll go to the table editor. We have profiles and quiz results. Under quiz results, we see the results are saved. So it did that correctly. And under profiles, we see my user. And then also, if we go to authentication and users, we can see the user created as well, and that it was signed in through email. So that is all working, and we can verify that by going into Supabase. And they also have preset links, so like manage users will probably take us to that users tab that we were just at. So we've built out our basic app structure, but you're probably thinking, how do I deploy this so that others can actually access this app? There are a couple ways to do this in Lovable, and I'm going to explain both of them. So the first way to do it is to just hit publish. We can go ahead and publish it, and it's going to publish on this Lovable subdomain, which you also can edit the subdomain of that. It just shipped. I can copy the link. And it's loading here in an incognito browser. And this is the app. It is now published and live under a domain through Lovable. That's one way to do it. The next thing you could do if you wanted to add your own custom domain is you can do that through Lovable directly if you want. You can click on add custom domain. You can add a domain, just connect it, follow the instructions to add your own domain. So that means if you want it to be, you know, personalityquiz.com, that is how you would do it directly through Lovable. Now, there is one other way to do it, and it's a little bit more advanced, but it is the way that I recommend doing this, is syncing to GitHub and then hosting elsewhere. The reason I like doing this is I like to get off of Lovable once I've built my app up to kind of this point and host it on GitHub. It gives us a couple benefits. One, and I'll just start doing it while I am talking about this. So again, if you don't have a GitHub account, you can create one for free and then just go and press that button and then connect it. I'm going to connect the project, which is just going to sync my code from Lovable to GitHub. So we can continue building in Lovable the exact same way. The difference is now my app is on GitHub. This is going to allow us to, one, sync GitHub with other Vibe coding tools like Cursor. If you want to use Cursor to continue building this, you don't have to continue building in Lovable. I have some videos about how to do that in more detail on the channel, so check those out. But then you can very easily connect your code from Lovable to GitHub. So it's going to sync to GitHub. Just go to the top, click connect to GitHub. If you don't have an account, just follow the steps to create an account and then connect it in one click. And what that is going to do is give you the ability to easily host your website. So you can do it on Netlify. Just create a Netlify account and then connect GitHub to your Netlify account. And then in one click, you'll have your website hosted. And you can also do that on Vercel in a very similar way. I'm going to tell you about a few more really important tips with Lovable that a lot of people miss. One is there's a code editor. So you can go into code mode here on the top and you can directly add and change the code. This can be really helpful if you just want to go in and like change the text of something. So that can be really helpful. If you need to understand more about how these files are configured, I recommend going to ChatGPT and asking, or just going into chat mode and saying, hey, what file is this in or that in? You'll start to get it pretty quickly. There's like something called components. This is like components that are reused throughout the app. There's pages. I don't want to go into too much detail here, but just know there is a code mode and then you can discard or save your changes. Next, you can invite users and collaborate on the same project with one user. So that's another pretty cool feature. On the top, you can go to different pages and test them out directly without having to go through and use the apps. There's also a feature down here on the bottom left called Edit, which allows you to select things directly. And then you can just in a more no-code way, so this is a little bit more like using Squarespace, you can just make changes here on the left, added all these exclamation points, and then it shows up in the actual app, and then you can save that. Now, the last tip is really important. This can take your Lovable building to the next level, is to go on the left and go to settings. And what we want to do is go down to knowledge. And this is where you can add instructions and guidelines to provide context to improve your project's edits. As you can see here, it's where you can set coding style preferences, external documentation or style guides. One example here would be to like share the way you want the style to be throughout the app. So it just knows that every single time. There's a lot you can do here. And if you click get inspiration, Lovable has a lot of information about what you can include in this knowledge space. But this is something that can make Lovable just more personalized to you. And I think is a really powerful and valuable thing that most people don't ever go to. Finally, within the project settings, what you can do is turn on a couple features. One is if you want to get rid of that Lovable badge on the live website, you have to be upgraded, but then you can just flip that switch. By default, they're going to have that Lovable badge on, so you need to go in and turn it off here if you want to. Renaming, remixing, deleting, and then categorizing your project. So those are all things you can do. And then private project. Again, if you're not on a pro account, it's going to be public, so just be aware of that. Otherwise, your project will be private. The last thing is security. We have a whole video on Lovable security, so be sure to check that out. But on a high level, a couple things you need to be aware of. One, under publish, Supabase is going to give you security warnings. So these are two things that you can say, hey, ask the chat. These are warnings that we are getting. Like, how do we fix this? Looks like it's just like leaked password protection disabled. So something that we can turn on within Supabase. One-time password expiry exceeds recommended threshold. We're not even using a one-time password right now, so that's not relevant, but these are really important to look at. The other piece of security that's super important is edge functions and API calls, and if you're using OpenAI, things like that. Now, Lovable will generally do this in the correct way, but you want to make sure that these are stored correctly in something called an ENV file, or within Supabase, there's something called secrets. If we go to Supabase, we go to edge functions, we go to secrets, so you can store your API keys here, like OpenAI, and make sure they're secure. Before you actually publish your app and have people use it, be sure to go in the chat mode and just say, hey, are all my API keys secure? And that's just something that can be really helpful. Or are there any security vulnerabilities I should be aware of? These are just best practices that you should know about when building with Lovable or any vibe coding tool. If you like this video, here's another video on the screen that you should check out that is going to help take your Lovable building to the next level by connecting to Cursor. Definitely recommend checking that out. And be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more free content like this. Leave a comment below if you have any questions at all. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.